Hi my love YouTubers, this is Nuna. I am coming at you guys to do a video. Well, I have been thinking about doing that series of video for a long time. And lately I have been having the requests or the suggestions. It is not specifically request, but it is just like, Nuna, can you talk about God and your relationship with God? And lately I have had a comment. It was more like a question. Let me read that to you. In the Our Father prayer, Jesus told us what are some of the things we should pray for. Hair is not on the level as anything he mentioned. I think God would be more concerned about helping the poor and sick, but hey, there are still around, so how come if he answered our prayers for longer hair, he has not answered their prayers? This was just a sober thought of the day. May you have peace and a lovely day. Thank you so much. She cutest. And before this one, you asked me, you can't refrain. You say, I can't refrain from saying though, that do you really think that the God that so many of us pray to for help with more serious problem, and yet they persist, he would actually be concerned about the growth of hair? Not in my opinion. I thank you for this topic. Oh, and people, please feel free to, you know, feed those videos, those series of videos that I'm about to do, with your questions and, you know, thoughts about God, so that we can share and experiment, and so that everybody can comment down here, you know, like, so that we can grow all together spiritually. Okay, thank you. So here's what I think. I think I'm too close to you guys. Let me check that out. Okay, so in my opinion, God takes control on everything that I do in my life. There is no single thing, like, in, okay, let me start by my body. From the top of my head until the bottom of my feet, God is in control. I have been suffering from so many stuff. People, you have got no idea. So many stuff. And if it was not for God, I wouldn't be here in front of you guys. I truly believe that when Lord said, may you all that are tired come to me so that I can take your burden, you know, I do believe that he does that. There ain't no single thing, you know, whenever I'm waking up in the morning and I have a flu or I have a headache or, you know, I just don't feel good. To my opinion, this trouble is not smaller than somebody that is living outside. It is different on different levels. You know what? I have been pregnant and I was living outside. I was pregnant with no home and God was there. And at that moment, my problem may have appeared bigger than somebody that was just, you know, like looking for a job. That person was having a home. I wasn't. I was having no job, no home, but my problem is not bigger than anybody else's, because this is my life. This is what God is making me go through. I cannot say that when it comes to my hair, it is something like, you know, huge. In my country, some kids are dying because they had nothing to eat, and I know that. In, for example, in Afghanistan, I think lately it is going on the news, there have been a tremblement de terre. I'm going to write the word here. And people have died. And I have been praying for them. And this does not make my prayer for my hair smaller than my prayer for those people and their family. Not at all. God is love for every single thing. I don't say that if, for example, you know, there is a natural catastrophe and a lot of people dies, it is something we all have to focus on and pray for. But this will not mean that God will not listen my personal prayer for my personal health or situation or needs. He said in his Bible that if you come to him with a problem, with a question, he will answer. I don't say that he will answer now. God is never on a hurry. He is never late. He is always on time. He does everything he wants, like he wants. Don't you ever go and think that because you are coming to God with a problem that might appear superficial, he will not answer to you. Uh-uh. Look at how far I have been coming with my hair. I have been praying to him, asking to him to give me the courage and strength. But I have been praying to him for other things. Please, God, help me find the strength to go back to school and have a better, a bigger degree so that I can find a better work, so that I can find, you know, a better situation, so that I can take care of my daughter, of this kid that you gave to me, you know. All of those prayers, they are all related, but this only concerns me. I don't think that praying for my hair is going to refrain God from helping others. I don't think that, because he said it. He is the Almighty. He said it in his word. He is the Almighty. So every single problems is good to give to him, you know, because he can do it. We as humans, we cannot do that. We just cannot. But he can. And I am so strongly, firmly convinced that he can do it. I come to him. God, I know my problem is not as big as some other people, but still, I know that you are the only one that can do that. So please hear me. I don't ask you, you know, to do something right now. I just want you to hear my prayer. Whenever you are praying to God, you do have got to believe that he hears you. He might not answer today or in 6 months or in 6 years, but he will answer. And at that moment, you will remember. I remember when I was, you know, outside, when I was homeless. It is not really homeless, but I was homeless. I was praying. I did a prayer. I asked God to give me a house that will be completely white and that will be having a huge room for the kid I was carrying. He gave to me. I wanted a white house. A clear house with a lot of lights. This is what I asked. Because you have got to be precise. When you're asking God something, you have got to be precise. You cannot say, God, I want to be in good health. Okay, this is good. But if you have got a heart problem, you have got to be precise. God, please make this heart problem disappear so that I can have overall good health. Give me a second. You have got to be precise when you ask God something, you know. And here I am, 5 years later. 5 years later. My daughter is 4 years and a half. So I was pregnant by that time. And I am in a huge apartment that is white. I have been painting it in white, but I had the right to do this, you know. The apartment is clear. My daughter's room is huge and the apartment is white. It took 5 years. 5 years. But it did happen. Oh, people, hallelujah. How can you want me not to believe that God is hearing all of our prayers? I firmly believe that he hears every single prayer. It might not, you know, it might seem superficial or kiddy, you know, but he does. I have experimented it. So I do know that he hears and he listens. Now, I totally understand Shikyu's opinion or point of view, because you know there are so many poor people and dying people and so many disease outside in the world. But I believe that he knows all about it and he knows what he's doing. I can't even think that he doesn't hear those people's prayers, because this will be refraining my Lord, and I am not taking that risk. I do believe him 800, 200, 1,000, a billion person. I believe him. That is just me. So people, whatever you think, please comment down here and I will answer, of course. And thank you so much for being there, and thank you so much for helping me grow spiritually, because this comment, you know, this comment is making me think and asking me questions, and this is how you grow. So people, I guess I will see you whenever I see you. Mwah. Bye guys.